all functions fx, this is fx, this can be transformed into another function which is gx using general transformation, and this transformation is a reflection, scaling and translation. So gx is transformed function, fx was put in here, and we have a, we are applying a, then we have k here, k, d and c. So these are the factors, or these are the values that correspond to the reflection, scaling and translation. So we have four parent functions, that is we have quadratic functions. So we just put in this place, we put x minus d whole square, radical we just take a root of x minus d, then reciprocal we just put it in the denominator, absolute we just put a modulus sign here. So let us take an example. First of all, if we want to transform a parent function fx into some gx where RST is applied, so there are two ways of obtaining gx from the parent function. What you can do is you can substitute fx into gx, then we determine the RST from the gx transformation and apply them. Either ways it works. First of all, the parent function is root x and it is transformed to say gx equal to half fx plus 3. How do we do that? First, to obtain gx, you will end up graphing use. How? First, fx is root x. So, fx plus 3 will be what? It will be under root x plus 3. Now, we will replace this fx plus 3 here, right? So, fx plus 3 under root x. So, gx will be half. What is x plus, fx plus 3? It is under root x plus 3. So, we will just put under root x plus 3 in place of fx plus 3. And when we compare this gx radical to the general radical transformation, we see that this is half under root x plus 3 plus 0. Let us compare gx with a under root x minus d plus c. This is the standard form. Here we have k also in between. And since there is no c here, we just add a 0. We add a 0 so that c value is more obvious. Well, it is not here. Now, what this a will be? A, this is half. So, a will be plus half. D is what? It is minus 3. And c is what? 0. So, now RST. Let us find out RST. A is half. For, because it is plus. So, there is no vertical reflection in y. But since a is positive, because it is half, so y has a which is positive. So, there is a reflection over there. And since we have the scaling, a is half, then we have, this is half is some, what, 0.5. So, it's a stretching in y. It is a equal to half, so it is stretching in y of the value 0.5. Then we come to d. D is minus 3 here. So, d is shift left. C is 0. That means though no up or down shift. Now, the second thing is determining the RST from gx transformation and then applying them. So, how do we do that? What we will do here is gx equal to half fx plus 3. Let us compare this to the general transformation, gx equal to a fx minus d plus c. A is half, d is minus 3 and c is 0. So, this gives us the same transformation as we have seen, that is r, there is no vertical reflection in y, and since a is positive, s is the a is half, so it is stretching by 0.5, it is positive. And then we have d is minus 3, which is shifting left, and c is 0, that means no up down shift. Now, the steps from method 1 and 2, they are always the same till this step to graph any transform function. The first step will always be determine the RSTs, that is the reflection, scaling and transformation variables. We create a RST chart, then key points. Then we graph fx to the parent function and transform it to gx function and determine the domain and range on the transform function, which is gx. So, how do we do that? Let us take another example. The parent function is 1 by x and gx is minus fx minus 5, 4. So this is fx, right? This just forget about x minus 5. This is fx. So here, now when we put x minus 5, we have to put x minus 5 here in order to replace this fx minus 5. So what we are doing here is fx is 1 by x. We substitute fx into gx. So fx minus 5 simply means 1 by x minus 5. So we are substituting fx minus 5 equal to 1 by x minus 5 here in this place. So gx becomes minus f, this minus fx minus 5 has to be replaced by 1 by x minus 5. Minus remains same, 4 remains same. Only this fx minus 5 has become 1 by x minus 5. So this minus just means a minus 1, okay. So we have to put a minus 1 here. Now let us compare this gx reciprocal to the general reciprocal function. This is minus 1, 1 by x minus 5 plus 4. Let us equate or relate it with the gx. Gx is a 1 by x minus d plus c. What is a here? Minus 1. See, a is minus 1. What is d here? D minus d is minus 5. That is d is 5. What is c here? C is 4. So we have a vertical reflection in y because a is negative. So there is a vertical reflection in y. Then a is 1. See, a is 1. That is, it is stretch in y by 1, which really means no stretch. So the a equal to 1 means no stretch. There is nothing going on. If it would have been, so say, 2, then it would have been a stretch in 2. But this is 1, so there is no stretch. D is 5, that means you are shifting it to right. And 4, c equal to 4 means you are shifting up by 4. So this is just the basic idea of the transformation. There are two ways you can do. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.